Hello friends, welcome to RR Digital Big Data Hadoop training.
Today's session we'll discuss about HBase commands. Okay, so before executing HBase commands, so first we have to enter in HBase shell mode. Okay, so for that we have to enter command HBase space shell. Okay, so this is the command which will take you to the HBase shell mode. Okay, so successfully logged in HBase mode. So here we can see HBase version 1.2.0 and Cloudera version 5.13.0. So first we'll check what other tables available in HBase. Okay, so to check existing tables we have to use list command. Okay, so here it is showing only a DEPT table. Okay, so only one table available, that is DEPT. And also if you want to check which user logged in, okay, then you have to give command who am I. Okay, so here it is showing Cloudera user logged in this console, and this particular user belongs to Cloudera group and default group. Next, how to create a table in HBase. Okay, so create table name employee. Okay, and the column family name. Okay, so this particular table belongs to which column family. Okay, so create table name employee. Okay, and column family name here CF1 I am giving. Okay, so before creating a table or while creating a table, compulsory we have to specify column family name. Okay, so table successfully created using list command. We can cross verify. So here it is showing employee table. So we have created table, but we have not specified any column names or we have not inserted any data. Okay, now we'll insert a few records. So before inserting, if you want you can describe a table. Okay, so this is the command, describe table employee. Okay, so here it is giving information, this particular employee table is there in enabled mode. Okay, so here we have two modes, enable mode and a disable mode. Okay, so here it is showing it is enable mode. Okay, and column family name which we defined, that it is showing here CF1. Okay, so these are backend by default, it will provide this information. Okay, these all are default configurations. Okay, so now we'll insert data. So to insert data we have to use a put command. Okay, put employee, then row key is mandatory, so row key 1 I am giving here, and then which column related data you want to insert, employee name. Okay, so before column name here we have to define column family name. Okay, and then employee name related value. Okay, so here I am giving Ram. Okay, so successfully inserted one record. Okay, so after inserting, how to retrieve the data from HBase table. So for that we have to use a scan command, scan in a table name. Okay, see here it is showing one record. Okay, and column family name, employee name, and value we inserted as Ram. Okay, and this timestamp, what time exactly we inserted. So we have inserted only one column related, but the same row, same record, I want to insert another column related data. Okay, so maybe salary related data also. Okay, so here maybe 5000. Okay, so this row key is same. Okay, so row key is same means we are inserting record in for a same. Okay, it is not different record. If you give here two means that is different record. Okay, but you are giving existing row key. That means this is a new column. New column value we are inserting into existing row. So successfully inserted, and again using the scan command we can check. Okay, so here it is showing only one row, because yes, only one row. Employee name and salary both are different columns, but a single record. Okay, single record contains two different columns related data, employee name and salary. Okay, now I will insert a different row. Here I am giving a row key 2. Okay, scan employee. See, now here it is showing two rows. Okay, because these two single record, this one single record. Now how to retrieve specific row key related data. Okay, so here get and then table name employee and then row key. Okay, so row key one related data you can retrieve. Okay, see, successfully retrieved a row key one related. Okay, so using the get command you can retrieve a specific row key related data. If you use a scan, by default all the records it will show. Okay, but based on a row key, if you want to retrieve data, you can use a get command. Okay, and if you want to check how many records are there in employee table, then you have to use a count and then table name. See, here is given count, right? Only two records are there. I want to check table is there in which mode. Okay, so here is underscore enabled and then table name. So it is giving a true, because our table is there in enable model. See, whenever generally we create a table, by default it will be enable mode. Okay, you can try disable also. Disabled is underscore disabled, what it will give? False, right? Because it is there in enable mode. Okay, now I want to disable this table. So disable, then table name, table disabled. Now you can cross verify is underscore enabled, what it will show? False, because disabled. And is underscore disabled, what it will display? True. Okay, so table successfully disabled. Why we have to disable table? So whenever you want to hide your table related data to others, then you can disable. Okay, so now if you try scan command, it will not give result, because it is there in a disable mode. Okay, that's why it will not give results. Now you can enable. Okay, and then you can try scan command. Okay, enable. So now table is enabled, so it will retrieve the data now. Okay, so basically this is about enable and disable. Okay, how to drop table? Drop or truncate. Okay, so drop table name employee. So if you want to drop table, first you have to disable. So disable table. Okay, table disabled. Now drop. Okay, so successfully dropped. See, list, it is showing only department table. There is no employee table. Okay, so now we'll create again a table. Okay, so here I will specify versions also. Okay, okay, table created and I specified three versions. Describe table name. Describe Okay, so here it is showing three versions. Okay, now we'll insert data. Okay, so using a put command, we'll insert a data using a put command. Okay, so here employee name I am inserting. Okay, name Ram. Okay, so this is V1 version related data. Now instead of Ram, I'm updating Sam. Now again, instead of Sam, Ramu. So in HBase, it will store last three versions related data. Okay, scan employee. But when you use a scan command, always it will read only latest value, not three. Okay, so here scan employee, then versions here three. See, successfully retrieved last three versions related data. Okay, so if you update a fourth value instead of Ramu, again if you give Ram one, means now it will give only three. So first value, this one it will remove, always only latest three. Okay, backend also it will keep only latest three values related data. Now how to truncate table. So truncate means data it will remove, but table it will keep. Okay, so here you can check a list, it is showing employee. Okay, but a data scan employee. Okay, because we applied a truncate. Okay, so data removed. Okay, so status simple. Okay, so generally this status command Hadoop admin team will use. Okay, so whenever they want to check a cluster related or HBase related information, so what all are nodes running backend and the server is live or not, how many backup servers are running. Okay, so that time they will use this command status simple. And also here it is showing how many number of regions also running. Okay, and instead of simple summary also you can try summary, just what is what it will give, how many servers, how many dead, how many are active, how many are running, like that. Okay, and the next one detailed. Okay, detailed means if each region server related, all the information it will show. Okay, basically this information required only for a Hadoop admin team. Okay, for developers it is not required, but just knowledge purpose I explained here. Okay,
please subscribe our channel for more training related videos. Also thanks for watching this session. Bye friends.